Swazdila, you hideous creatures. How the hell are ya? Today, I will show you the DPS Banshee build people cried about not too long ago. I like to call this build, the Kale Floor Banshee. Before I say anything further though, I feel compelled to say this. The best way to play Banshee, is to not play her at all. And the only good Banshee is a dead one. You think I'm kidding? Then you are right. I am joking. Banshee is a great warframe and, above all, she is a sensitive little bitch. Just like many of my haters. Moving on. The Kale Floor Banshee build is pretty straightforward and will never run out of energy. It is strong enough to easily do every defense mission on the star chart. You can even clear sorties with this build with a little help from appropriate warframes and capable teammates. Oh wait. It is also my number one go-to build for this annoying Riven. And also not bad for focus farming either. Now then, to make sure you never have an energy problem, I like to use Zenuric. But I am a Zenuric pleb by default and you actually do not have to rely on this focus school if you do not want to. Because the second little min-max thing I like to do is grab a syndicate weapon that can proc either Blight or Entropy. The Blight effect can be used by the two Red Veil guns and these four mobs on the respective weapons. The Entropy effect is granted by the two Cephalon suited guns and these four mods. Blight will burst viral damage and regen some energy for a few seconds. Entropy will give back energy immediately on burst and also grant energy regeneration. So which you prefer, is up to you. Me? I prefer Blight because I don't have energy issues in the first place, and that viral proc will help kill off stubborn higher level douchebags. Okay. Before I get to the build, I have an announcement to make. Some wonderful Ashisogi Tenno clanmates worked really hard to establish the official Ashisogi Tenno community Discord. Join in if you want, and we can interact more directly than ever before. We even have a Warframe meme channel. Need I say more? I don't think so. So get your sexy ass over here, and hang out with us scum. Now shut up and continue watching this video. So here is the build. Ignore Steel Charge. I am not ready to waste the forma on Banshee so I left it as is. Obviously, you can tweak this shit to your personal liking, but for me this works wonderfully. Keep in mind, this is a very specific build that I cannot recommend using in any other situation other than fast clearing and protection. As long as you use this for what it is meant for, you should be fine. One more quick tip. In order to reach maximum effect, you will not want to spam 4 like a maniac. Instead, hit sonar to mark the enemies on the map. Watch them carefully and allow them to get as close as you can bear. Then when they are close, smash that earthquake on their asses. Why? Because Banshee deals most of her damage at the epicenter. So the further away the douchebags are, the less damage you deal. That is why you will want them in close. So then, that is all I have to say about his build. Give it a shot. Or don't. Now like and subscribe to this shitty channel for more garbage every week. Now fuck off.
Master Jizo, please be honest. On a scale from 1 to 10, how much do you like me?
-11.